BBC News. Hello, I'm Eileen McHugh. Germany's governing Christian Democrats are celebrating an emphatic victory in the state of Saxony-Anhalt, the last poll before national elections in September. The party secured about 37% of the votes. The anti-immigrant AfD party trailed 16 points behind. Jenny Hill is in Berlin.
The CDU is dwindling on a national level. Angela Merkel steps down at that election. The new party leader, Armin Laschet, has really struggled to reinvigorate public support for the party. So this is a really important victory for him, for the party. They'll no doubt be very relieved in Berlin. The story, of course, in Saxony-Anhalt was all about the far right. The far right party, AfD, has been doing better in Germany's former east than in other parts of the country, a significant challenge in Saxony-Anhalt. And that had really sparked a very painful debate within the CDU about how to deal with the far right.
An estimated 93 million Mexicans are voting in wide-ranging elections, which are being seen as a referendum on the president, Andrés Manuel López Obrador. He's hoping his Morena party will retain its two-thirds majority in Congress to continue the social and welfare reforms he calls the fourth transformation. Will Grant has more.
Turnout will be pretty crucial. Obviously, there are parts of the country which will involve a certain degree of violence that we've seen, one of the bloodiest election campaigns in recent Mexican history. And of course, that may force certain voters to stay at homes through fear, through intimidation. For those who have turned out, thus far, broadly speaking, it's gone off quietly. We've seen some images of irregularities at a few polling stations, but by and large, people have been voting in an atmosphere of calm.
Colombia's president says his government will modernise the police after widespread allegations of human rights abuses during long-running street protests. Iván Duque said he'd ask Congress to approve a series of measures, including human rights training. Both candidates in Peru's runoff presidential election have cast their votes in what's expected to be a very tight contest. Keiko Fujimori, the right-wing daughter of a jailed former president, is up against her left-wing rival, Pedro Castillo, the son of peasant farmers. A leading Kremlin critic, Dmitry Gutov, says he's left Russia for Ukraine because of pressure from the authorities ahead of the September Duma elections, Sasha Schlichter reports.
Dmitry Gutov was picked up earlier in the week and held for 48 hours. He denies allegations that he has anything to do with a property with outstanding rental payment. On Sunday night, he crossed the border and drove into Ukraine. In a Facebook post, he wrote, "People close to the Kremlin told him if he did not leave, he would be rearrested." He added, his family too had received threats.
World News from the BBC. Two leading Palestinian activists have been detained for questioning by Israeli security forces in the Sheikh Jarrah neighbourhood of East Jerusalem that's been at the heart of recent protests. Muna and Mohammed El-Kurd have used social media to bring the issue of the potential eviction of long-time Palestinian residents, including their own family, to international attention. The man poised to take over as Israel's new prime minister has urged Benjamin Netanyahu to give up his attempts to cling on to power. Naftali Bennett said Israel was not a monarchy and people had a right to choose a new government.
I call from here on Mr. Netanyahu. Let go. Release the country to move on. People are allowed to vote for the establishment of a government, even if it's not you who are heading it. A government that's 10 degrees to the right of the current one, by the way.
He also urged the Speaker of the Knesset to hold the final vote on the new coalition government on Wednesday. Mr. Netanyahu's supporters have been pressurising right-wing MPs to abandon the multi-party coalition before it takes power. He has branded it the greatest election fraud in the history of democracy. The West African branch of the Islamic State group known as ISWAP has said the leader of the rival militant group Boko Haram is dead. An audio recording from ISWAP said Abu Bakr Shekau blew himself up following a battle. Reports that the Boko Haram leader had been killed first emerged last month. His death has not been confirmed by the Nigerian authorities. The England bowler, Ollie Robinson, has been suspended from international cricket. An investigation is underway into tweets he posted when a teenager in 2012 and 2013 containing racist and sexist terms. They emerged on Thursday at the start of his debut test against New Zealand. Robinson said he was ashamed of his inexcusable remarks. BBC News.